Hello everybody and welcome back to the Mega Modded series. We're jumping in again, and I did already unfortunately start a run. That's why a streak has been reset, and it was indeed, as you can see, as Tainted Jacob to Mother. I will be sticking rigidly to that plan. I did tweak the thingy a little bit, the randomizer, to up the chances of Tainted Lazarus, Tainted Jacob, and a few other things like Mother and the Beast, just to make it a little more fair, because I had them tweaked prior. And especially now this character's been changed, I think it's a good idea to give him another shot. I haven't played him since he's been changed. Of course, now Izao is invincible. Glass Eyes, awesome. We can shoot through and stuff like that. And yeah, he's just all round a much, much better character, much more interesting to play, much more enjoyable. I've heard a lot of good things about him, so I'm actually quite excited to give this a go. Now, that doesn't mean I'll do well by any means, but at least now we have a better chance. I've still got the Dark Izao helper on to try and keep us going, just so we can use him for damage a bit. Also, he now breaks boss DPS cap. Oh, that's great. Does this work on Izao? I very highly doubt it. No. Okay. That would have been great. Would have been great. Yeah, unfortunately, pretty useless first item here, I've got to say. Just managed to get all of those to kill each other. That's kind of funny. Right. Yeah, I don't really think I need any of this. I am going to do an attempt on a donation machine break. Yeah, that was unfortunately pretty pathetic. I will at least buy the soul heart then. I was hoping to get enough to buy the coupon just because it's much better than what we currently have, but we'll just take what we got and we'll go. Let's head on out. But yeah, it's going to be interesting playing Tainted Jacob with the new changes for the first time in a while. He seems much, much better now, as I mentioned, and just much more tolerable. And there's a lot less like issues and ways to die via bullshit. Ooh. The Avenger Emblem, another flat one damage up. This is some good damage ups. I'm going to go down to the normal floor first and then come back to the downpour. We do have enough money, but I don't think it's worth going downpour quite yet. And we got a library here, which is really nice. Okay, did not mean to lock the spider, as you might imagine, but we'll take it. Okay, let's see what's in here. Nice. Okay, we get the Satanic Bible, which is actually very, very good for us, because we can steal devil deals here. So very excited about that. I'll definitely try and make sure to remember to actually go to the, oh my god, what is this room? I swear, the creator of the dumpy mod that adds all these dumpy rooms just went ham on the spikes to the nth degree. Like, it is egregious how many spikes there are in dumpy rooms. Okay, we should be fine. But yeah, we can use the ghost form to steal the devil deal that we get from Satanic Bible. So we're pretty much fine to use it. I got hit already. Okay, that's really not good. wasn't expecting to get hit quite so soon. I'll let you know that for sure. That was a ginormous misplay by me. But that's the way the cookie crumbles, I guess. Let's just play it safe, I guess. Hope for the best. I will definitely die here. These little things... Okay, we actually did great there. But these little things hit me so often. Just because of that little burn that they throw. Oh my god. Okay. I do not like Dumpies plus Dark Izao. That is horrible. Dumpies plus Dark Izao is a very scary combination. This is quite funny. But we can now pick up hearts while in ghost form as Tainted Jacob, which is a huge, huge improvement on this character. Just makes him so much better. Okay, let's keep it going on these dudes. They're actually really not that hard to kill. So we can actually use this and gain hearts out of it. Okay, that was insanely good damage off the bat there. And we got him. And now we can steal this. We can go in here and we can... What the hell's this? Let's just take a little look at what we got here. So of course we got Goathead, which is fantastic. Spawns four familiars with different effects. Greed takes money, HP, and HP from enemies. Pride deals quick damage to enemies spawned from another enemy. Wrath punches and knocks enemies back. Oh, we gotta try this. It's weird. We gotta try it. What on earth is going on right here? I really wanted to take Goathead, but you just... What the hell is this? It's also a tainted item, which if you didn't know, tainted items are pretty cool. They come from the Job mod, and basically they're unlocked as extras. I've got 100% completed save file for Job, but you can unlock them via extras, and you can, like, earn like, a currency to unlock them with. But yeah, this is, intriguing, to say the least. The fact that we got conjoined already is pretty crazy as well. Conjoined isn't that good for us just because we have really low fire rate at the minute, but... My god. This is mental. Absolute familiar train. Gonna make sure to use our book before we, fight a boss. It's gonna get kind of confusing with Tinted Jacob, I won't lie. Oh, honestly, Dumpies are gonna be the death of me. Dumpies are gonna be the death of me. They keep pushing me into Tainted Jacob. Ooh, we actually got the spaceship here. Moves around the room, scanning things. Okay, we'll take it. Why not? I remember this item being not all that good last time I used it, but maybe it's better. Maybe it's been tweaked. We're getting a lot of money. What? That creep's still there? God damn it. But yeah, essentially we can put this over an enemy. It stays over it for long enough and it does some stuff. Candle. Oh, don't steal my charges, you little shitbags. I can't even see Ezao most of the time here. We've got the scented candle as well. God damn. This is crazy. We've got such a mental build going on here. What the hell? Stop pushing things around. Heartbreak. I guess. I'll just take it. Put the damage up. Why not? This is the weirdest run. This run is so bizarre. I barely know what's going on. If we don't die in the mirror dimension here, I will be surprised. Oh, what? I got hit from a holy mantle because he spawned in front of me rather than behind me. This is just nuts. It's just nuts. I can't fathom. Whoa, these guys have like a blinded thing? They got like a little thing above their head that says they're blinded. What the heck? Okay, that room's done apparently. Oh my god. What have I created? It's like 2 seconds into the run, my guy. What is this? Oh my god. I've hardly had time to process what's going on. I have to admit, I think the spaceship was maybe a mistake. He's just kind of visual clutter at this point. My lord. Did not mean to do that very clearly, but here we are. Wasted a single bomb. Okay. Yeah, I don't know how to feel about Heartbreak. I really think Heartbreak needs a little bit of a buff. You should be getting a lot more damage for your broken hearts than you currently do. A lot more. Like, you really don't get much at all. God. He gave us a pill for killing that dude. Don't think we need the key, really. It's too much of a risk. Rooms like this always confuse me. Ones that you can complete before the challenge really starts. God damn the spikes. Hey, Ezao. Welcome to the party, pal. I'm loving these familiars, though. These, like, greed and lust and all that crap. They're amazing. They're confusing, but they're amazing. a cat in a box. When entering a room while enemies with enemies, their health is halved for the first 3 seconds and restored back to full. Oh, interesting. Intriguing. So if we kill enemies in the first 3 seconds, it's going to be a hell of a lot easier. Which I think is pretty reasonable for us. Pretty reasonable. This is, it's like, how is this run so modded as well? That's another thing. This run is so unbelievably modded. Like, we have so many modded items already. It's kind of bizarre. I love runs like this though, where it just kind of goes ham on the modded side of things and it just creates a whole different world. You just don't even know what's happening half the time. And then we got fucking Jacob in there doing his thing too. It's just funny. I don't even know what, like, I literally have no idea where Izao is until that line appears. Thank God we've got the Dark Izao Helper mod on, because otherwise I would literally have zero idea what was happening ever. I never know where he is. Oh my God. Why is he not aiming towards me? Okay, unfortunately, apparently cannot hit this guy while he's invulnerable with Dark Izao. I, for some reason, thought you could. I love the respray on this guy. I'll say it every single time. Why the hell not? At this point, I'm just taking every familiar I can. Salvation? Yeah, why not? What? I forgot to... I'm an idiot. I forgot to make myself into ghost form before taking those. So I actually just spent real HP on those. Whoopsie. Luckily we have this here. I did not mean to do that, but we seem to have somehow come out of it with more HP. I genuinely don't understand, but we somehow came out of this with more HP. I completely forgot that that was a hard requirement there. Oh, God damn it. Yeah, so that was a real, real big mistake. Taking, what's it called? Blood Earth. Oh, my God. Come on, dude. You have to put show up right now. I'm doing things. I'm busy. Busy, my guy. Can't you see that? My God. Oh, fucking hell. I'm taking random. Yes, another modded item. I don't know what it, wait a minute. We can actually take a look at what it does now with the, is it C? Encyclopedia. I installed this so we can take a look at our inventory and go down. Look based, pick up drops on kill. Okay. So the higher our luck, the more pickups we're going to get on killing enemies, by the sounds of it. I don't know why we're glowing red. Whoa, this guy looks awesome. Why does he look so cool? My God, red health. I can't believe it. Oh, this is the strangest, just the strangest setup. More hearts, thank you. Okay, another one of those. Oh, no thank you. Well, that guy got feared. I don't know how he got feared, but I'll take it. He's like completely stuck in there. Or at least he was. This is a horrible room for Dark Izao here. Okay, luckily that dude did manage to take him out a little bit there. More money somehow. Greed just keeps taking money. It's great. No, oh, Dark Izao so nearly got me then. So nearly got me. We'll grab that, why not? We'll grab that. Oh God. I don't know how to feel about this. This is very strange. What on earth is going on? My damage and my luck. What on earth is happening? I like it. I like it. I'll accept it. Oh my god. We've got 1,000 luck and 1,000 range, nearing 1,000 damage too. Oh, sausage. Yeah, get some snats in there. Join the party, why not? Oh my god, luck-based pickups too. Enemies are dropping like fucking 40 chests when they die. Oh, well, this is intriguing to say the least. Wow. Okay, we hard broke the game here. Like, there's some modding breaks. Basically, from what I understand, what's going on is that item increases our damage and range and luck per familiar that we have. But the way that there's the familiar from that contract thing we got at the start, the lust and greed dudes, is initialized, is flawed, and it gives you them every second for some reason. And that causes an infinite loop. Wait a minute, I'm very confused at where I'm meant to be going here. They added new mother routes in the latest update, and I didn't know. So there's going to be a bunch of places here that I just do not understand. Yeah, I don't care about getting hit by you all that much. God damn, this is crazy. This is so much harder than all the other ones. But I do like that. They did need to be some harder ones. But this is, especially with fucking Dark Ezao as well, this is mental. This is so difficult. This layout specifically is kind of impossible. Yeah, like, basically impossible. God damn. This is obscenely difficult. There's just no way to not get hit by that guy. Just fuck off, mum. This is obscenely difficult. Holy hell. Okay. God damn. Don't worry, our stats are back. We don't need health where we're going. This is, quite something. Y'all never seen stats this high. My goodness, this is just absurd. Wait a minute, let me go back and get the red health. Real quick. No! It put me down the wrong thing, you... I can't see because of all these puffs of smoke. It's fine, whatever. We're not going mother now. Look at the amount of drops that enemies are giving. This is so dumb. I love it. Literally every enemy drops like 3 pickups. A tier size. Oh, it's so huge. of that. Just a few little pickups for me there. Wait, is there spikes? There's spikes in the middle of this room. Hey. Increase or decrease luck a random amount and walking into a room. I don't think we really need that, I'll be honest. The problem at the minute is I just cannot see what the hell's going on. I'm just never aware of what's happening because I can't fucking see anything. Look at this. A golden penny, why not? Wait, what? Is it there? I'm always really bad at finding the secret room. Okay, I can't get it. Item room? Look at the minimap. Fuck me. I think we'll be okay, thank you. Holy hell. I've never seen stats this high. And they just keep climbing. Oh my god. Hey, Mum. Let's go with Acid Shot, just so we destroy every rock in every room instantly. Imagine if you could kill Dark Ezo, he'd be so dead. Like, literally our tears are so big that you can't see them anymore. Like, we can barely fire. I was kind of hoping it'd just destroy all the rocks, but apparently not. Guppy's head there. Y'all think we need some flies in this? There's a golden bomb just chilling in the corner there. This is quite insane. I don't even know what to tell you, really. This is modding for you, baby. This is modding for you, baby. This is how it goes. Just a mere 4,000 luck. My god. I'm really looking forward to seeing what the stat gets up to by the end of the episode. God damn. I'm just accidentally opening, like, chests all the time and stuff as well. Somehow I should pick up a soul heart there. Don't know how Dark Ezo hasn't hit me yet. The lag is getting quite palpable. I can really feel it. That was the last wave, though. There you go. It spawned an item somewhere, but God knows where. Oh, it's Isaac's Jar of Tears. We'll be swiftly moving on. Oh my god. What have I created? What have I become? Do-do-do-do-do-do. Oh my god. I love how crazy this is. I can't believe that the fishing rod as well makes it so funny. Sinus infection, hell yeah. Oh, look at all the chests. A luck penny. Just what we needed. A little bit of luck to keep us going. Oh my god. I'm gonna have to tell the developer about this bad interaction here. Oh my god. rainbow chest there. Not that we can get to it right now. Hans, can you just come down and give me a break, please? Let me out of this hellscape. Wait, again, what's alive? How are things even surviving any of this? We cover the room in a tier so huge. Booster pack, hell yeah. We got a foil card out of it. Teleport to special arcade. It's not a special arcade though, it's just a regular arcade. It lies to me. God damn. This is just, oh yeah, get a bit of that extra damage there from Blood Earth. That's really what we're looking for, the Blood Earth damage. The Blood Earth damage is the thing to carry us. Oh my god, straight to the boss. I do wonder if I can one-shot Hush. I've got to see if I can one-shot Hush. Just 6,000 damage, you know me. Astral projection, why not? Black candle for no curses, that sounds good. A few consumables here and there, might need them. Well, that's one phase one shot. Yep, that's both phases one shot. Let's go Delirium, I think we have to. I think with this damage we have to. Yeah, this will be something I instantly report to the devs, because this is just a bit crazy. I just, the secondary effect of the luck creating all, the luck getting drops on kill. Plus, like, 7,000 luck is just, it's so funny. Ooh, astral projection has made weird things happen. I very much regret breaking up astral projection now. That is most bizarre. I don't even know where I am. Oh, hey, Reap Creep. How you doing? Basically, I create a game break looking room every single room. What the hell? Right. Just keep swimming. Just keep swimming. What? How is something alive in this room? Oh, it's a pin, that's why. Let's find the bosses as quick as we can. My god. Loaded dice. Grants plus 10 luck for the current room. Oh, what an effect. 10 luck. Oh my god. Exactly what we need. Okay, I got hit somehow. Okay, astral projection is going to mean that we die, I think. Because we just can't see and Dark Ether is going to get us. What on earth is this room? No wonder I got hit upon walking into it. What on earth is this? Nice. Few bombs there. Golden Penny. Not seen a single boss yet, which is... There you go, finally. The cage. Hopefully we'll find a few more bosses here. Because they seem to be somehow quite rare. Okay, good. Oh, there was enemies there. I need to fucking stop firing with astral projection. It just makes it impossible to see. Hey, Isaac. Oh, we're guppy. That's gonna add to the carnage. If we have any flies, they're gonna do twice our damage on one hit. Just keep swimming, swimming. Oh my god. Brownie, dead. Bit of speed up, there you go. Exactly what we needed. Like, it's just so funny to me that we don't even see our tears anymore. They're that big. Ask actual Skolex now. Or Babylon. Why not? Where the hell is Delirium? Need to find him soon. Nope. You almost got me, fella. You almost got me. I will not have this. You will not catch me. I will reach 10,000 damage. Again, how is anything alive in this room? Dude, how is that enemy alive? There's an enemy down here that I cannot kill. I thought they fixed this bug. There's a bug where you, like, couldn't kill enemies. Yeah, he's literally invincible. I can't kill him. Hmm. Bit stuck here. Like, look, this dude just won't die. Like, there's nothing we can do to kill him. And we can't bomb out of the room either, because... Like, how do I do this? Is there, like, a kill-all thing? Oh my god, there's some stuff going on in here. Kill. No? I don't know how to fix this. Yeah, this dude's just completely stuck. They definitely fixed this in a recent update. They said they did. He just keeps spawning consumables when I hit him. It technically classes this as killing him, so... I need to... Basically... Okay, I've got an idea of how I'm gonna fix this. It's a bit janky, but essentially, I need to keep hitting him until I get enough wooden chests to get a teleport card. There you go. Real jank way of fixing that, but it did work. Now I just gotta hope he's not a champion again when I walk in, because they do change. Okay, keep her going. My goodness. Okay, so we've basically cleared out every room, so it pretty much is that boss. We reached 10,000 damage and luck, but of course. This is hilarious. I've never seen a run more broken than this. Never in my life. Right, hope it's not broken this time. It's still broken, but literally the only room, that we need to get through to progress. And the game be like, nah. I don't really know how we fix this. Because he's just never gonna... I'm trying to think of ways that would work to kill him, but... I just don't think there are any. How could our journey come to such an end? I can't believe you've done this to me, game. Throw a bomb down and it does not end up at all where I placed it. I don't know how we're gonna kill him. There's gotta be a command for killing enemies, but I don't know what it is. Let me go see if I can find out. One second. Okay, I somewhat fixed it. I basically just reloaded the void floor. and we basically gotta hope that this time it works. Like, it's the same floor as last time. It's the exact same layout, so we know where we're going. But I'm just hoping that this time it no longer has a thingy on it, an enemy with that champion effect. Or we get there before Ezel spawns, which is another possibility. It was somewhere over this way, but I'm having trouble finding it. Maybe I'll just give myself, because we already found the floor, like give myself the mind, just to know where I'm going. Try and speed things up a little bit for you guys. But it's this one up here. This is so nuts. Oh my god, it's still fucking, what? How? Okay, let's just go give D10. No, that's D, what the hell? That's the D infinity. C238, was it? No, give D10. 285, C285. Get gone, you stupid shithead. I don't know why I didn't think of that earlier. That's the obvious strategy here, right. In we go. It's not even delirium. What? Where else? What? What boss did I miss? I'm confused. Was it this boss down here? Somehow? No, this was Skorlex. I'm very confused. What boss did we miss last time? Oh, that's a spike block. God damn it. What? I'm so confused. Super bandage, there you go. 1 minute. Big old sneeze, my god. Genuinely, it's gotta be this one all the way over here. Oh, for fuck's sake, astral projection is so annoying. As long as we don't shoot, everything will be fine. I keep accidentally walking to spikes and stuff. It literally has to be this one all the way over here that I somehow didn't go to before. Unless we got a delirium floor with no delirium. That'd be kind of funny. No, it's not this one. We did this one. This is Cage. This is also very confusing. What the heck? Is it this? Nope, it's not this one. Also, I fired. I didn't mean to. I'm sorry. We're losing health so rapidly right now. Nope, it's also not this one. We might actually die. This is Isaac. Where the hell is Delirium? Oh yeah, double room drops. That's what we need. There ain't enough bosses. My brain scrambled, boys. And gals. Okay, I don't know how we missed this last time, but there you go. We one-shot him. He's dead. Just, you know, 13,000 damage. Oh, I astral projectioned. How? In the last room. Stop it, astral projection. You're so annoying. Anyhow, we'll end it off there. I hope you guys enjoyed that 13,000 damage run. And I'll see you guys in the next one.